Hi, my name is Ricardo Böhme and I'm working as an application engineer for our flow measurement products here at SIC. Today we would like to have a closer look about the extended commissioning of a gas flow meter FLOWSIC500 by using our user software FLOWgate. Before we get started, all these steps described in the operating instructions, Chapter 3 installation, must be completed. If stipulated by national regulations, all actions interfere with meteorologically relevant parameters, the commissioning needs to be done under official supervision. You need probably to coordinate that with the authorities. To start with the commissioning, we need to power on the device and to connect to it. A data connection can be established by using an infrared USB adapter. Please note that you have to install device drivers before using the adapter with your PC. Device drivers as well as the user software FLOWgate can be installed from the product CD, which will be delivered with the FLOWSIC500. Otherwise, you can use the download link in the video description. Connect the USB plug to your PC and add the adapter to the optical interface of the FLOWSIC500. Press any button on the display to activate it. This will also enable the optical interface. Now you can establish a connection via FLOWgate. This connection remains active until you will remove the infrared USB adapter. To begin our commissioning, we need to open our user software FLOWgate. Add the FLOWSIC500 to the device manager of FLOWgate's operating software and create a connection to the device. We will log in with user level authorized user or higher. Please check your associate manual for the standard password for authorized user. Start the field setup wizard and follow the step-by-step instructions. To start the field setup wizard, the configuration mode must be activated to change parameters. Therefore, click on the wrench icon in the toolbar to activate the configuration mode. First step in the field setup wizard is the device identification. Check the device serial number and type code. Compare the entries against the type plate and enter a device name. In the next step, system user, you can edit date and time and execute the user management. Enter the date and time or synchronize with the PC. After completing commissioning, the daylight saving time settings can be activated and configured. For the user management, SIC recommends changing the initial password provided for the authorized user for security reasons. Further users can be activated if desired. Activate the associate checkbox of the desired user. Specify a password. The password must include 4 digits. Up to 3 users and 3 authorized users can be activated. Authorized user 1 and user 1 are always activated. If you click on Next, you will face the page Warnings. Here you can enter or configure different limits for the FLOWSIC500 when it should output warnings or errors. There's a possibility to set limits for the following values, which are flow rate, pressure, temperature, reverse flow volume, and a limit value for low flow rate or zero flow cutoff. In addition, the warnings signaled by the device can be individually activated or deactivated in the user warnings activation area. In the next step, we will take care about the communication. The configuration of the single plug-in connectors is preset according to the configuration ordered. Check the configuration and adapt when necessary. For pulse outputs, the maximum frequency and the minimum pulse width must be set during commissioning. The status outputs are configured as standard so that the status measurement invalid is already selected. The digital output of plug 1 B-coded can be configured as status or pulse output. Select the desired configuration. When configuring as a pulse output, enter the maximum frequency and the minimum pulse width in the pulse 1 area. When configuring as a pulse output, make sure that the overload frequency of 120% of Qmax is covered and that the connected device understands the frequency. Depending on customer specifications, the A-coded plug 2 is configured as status pulse output or as a serial interface like RS485. enter the maximum frequency and minimum pulse width in the pulse to area when configuring as a pulse output. In the next step, we perform a communication test. The test frequency will be output on all pulse outputs. Also, for the flow rate, enter the desired test flow rate and start the test. For the digital output test, select the desired digital output and move the slider to on. During the communication tests, the meter will count all values into an error volume counter. For devices with the option volume conversion, reference values must be determined in the following steps. Input the specifications for the gas properties, select the algorithm and parameters for the calculation of the compressibility factor. Enter the fixed values. At the Totalizers tab, you can set or reset counter readings. Determine the limits for the reverse flow volume. At the meter settings, configure the significant digits for the meters. Determine the resolution for the meters. The Totalizer resolution can be set in the range from 0.001 to 100 in increments to factor 10 for the volume at flowing conditions and the volume at base conditions for the meter. It is therefore necessary to multiply the Totalizer level with the corresponding Totalizer resolution to interpret the Totalizer level. Last but not least, you have the option to empty the logbooks and archives. Activate the checkbox for the logbooks and archives to be emptied. Click Clear selected. Check the collection status. If desired, reset the event overview. To create a parameter report, click on Create Parameter Report. The report is generated. File the report with the device documentation. After the commissioning, we can activate and configure the daylight saving time. To activate and configure the daylight saving time, open the tile system user in the parameter modification area. Activate the configuration mode and activate the daylight saving time. Next, click on plus to enter a new time period for daylight saving time. Set the start of the daylight saving time. Date can also be entered by using the keyboard. Then set the end of the daylight saving time. Click write to device to write the daylight saving time to the FLOWSIC500. Enter further time periods when desired. Daylight saving time start and end can be configured for up to 10 years in advance. Select the type of power supply corresponding to the configuration of the FLOWSIC500. This can be dynamic mode, battery mode, and echo mode. To complete the commissioning of the FLOWSIC500 via FLOWgate, we need to check the device status. Click on the symbol in the status bar when warnings or error exists. The current status overview opens and shows details and information on how to proceed. We have reached the end of our video and I would like to thank you for your attention. If you have any open questions, please feel free to get in touch with your local SIG subsidiary. Please refer also to our user manuals and operating instructions. Thank you for choosing SIG and stay healthy.